She had a lot of modern concerns, like the state of our planet and the behaviour of mankind and the fate of the animal and bird life.
Ian Hampton was the cellist of Vancouver's Purcell String Quartet. The group specialized in the work of contemporary Canadian composers. They performed Pentland's chamber works extensively in Canada and abroad.
Barbara's language is very cool, if you like, wonderfully well structured, tremendous clarity, and I have to say that I've always found Barbara's music very convincing, and whenever we return to those pieces, as it were, to relearn them as quartets tend to do, I was always struck by the strength of her construction and the clarity of her ideas. We played quite a lot of Canadian quartets one way or the other. To my mind, the composers which probably come off best are those of Murray Schaeffer and those of Barbara. The style, somebody described Barbara's music as being a little glacial, not in movement, I don't think, but perhaps glacial in harmonic language. Those are the things which prevent the music from being appreciated right now. But the qualities that are inherent in that music, I'm sure will be rediscovered by string quartet. I think if you're educated musicians who have been playing string quartets for any time at all, it should be quite obvious how good these quartets are.
Underhill hears an increasing warmth and concern with color in the music of Pentland's last years.
Barbara's music pays a lot of attention to color and sonority, certainly music of the last 10 years. So if you listen to those pieces, they're just full of different sonorities, and she was very inventive in that way. And her approach to harmony and the piano writing, I think, is also there's a very sensitive ear to voicing in there.
She wrote extremely well for the piano. She was a good pianist.
Robert Rogers premiered many of Pentland's piano works. In 1985, he recorded an entire album of her piano compositions for the Centrediscs label.
At the end of my recording the collection of the piano music, I left the five ephemera till the end of the session, and everything went swimmingly until the last piece, Persiflage, which I had played many, many times. But near the beginning of the piece, there's a little lick that is tiddly tiddly boom, ending on a single note. At least there was a single note on the page. And I split it. And I split it again, and I split it a third time, and I decided that I had to have a little break. And as I stood up, Barbara, who was sitting in the front row of the recital hall with the score, looked up and said, "I like it. I'll write it in if you like."
She wrote very well for instruments other than the piano and string quartet, which are great pieces. The Comenta harp solo is an excellent piece. It's one of the best Canadian pieces for harp, and it uses, you know, extremes, the high repeated notes and the right at the top range of the harp, and it's a very expressive piece. So I think she was quite a coloristic composer, and particularly in later years.
On the occasion of Pentland's 75th birthday, Two New Hours host Augusta LePay asked the composer about these new directions.